Hello, my name is Claudia Paoletti. I'm a scientist and I work in EFSA, the European Food Safety Authority. I'm here today to talk to you about the work we do on genetically modified organisms and why we do this work. Let's start from the beginning of the story. What is a genetically modified organism? It is an organism in which the genetic material has been altered or changed in a way that does not occur naturally. And by naturally we mean, for example, in the case of a GM plant, when we combine a father plant with a mother plant to obtain a new plant. Scientists are developing many different types of GM plants to achieve different objectives. For example, they have developed plants which are called drought resistant, meaning that they can survive well also when water availability is quite limited. Other type of plants are called insect resistant, and this is the example we'll be using today to explain a few things. Here you see two drawings. We have the non-GM maize plant and we have the GM maize plant. What's the difference between the two? On the non-GM maize plant, we have insects that can feed on it, on its leaves, whereas these are absent here because this plant is resistant and the insects cannot feed on its leaves. Now, what is the job of EFSA? The job of EFSA is to assess whether this plant is as safe as this one, the non-GM counterpart. Now, the question is, how does EFSA do this assessment? Using a comparative approach, which is basically a comparison between the GM plant and its conventional counterpart. We do that by asking a whole series of questions. For example, is this plant as nutritious as the non-GM counterpart for animal and humans when used in food and feed? Another question, does this plant causes any allergic reactions to human or animals when used in comparison to the non-GM counterpart? Or is this plant toxic for animal and humans in comparison to the non-GM counterpart when used? In addition to that, we also ask a whole series of questions to assess whether this plant causes any harm to the environment when cultivated. After we collect all this amount of scientific information, we use it to compile a document, which in EFSA we call scientific opinion. And this scientific opinion is then delivered to policymakers. This document contains all the information and the evaluation of the safety of the GM plants. In such respect, EFSA is not in favor nor against GMOs because it does purely a scientific work. And its opinion is used then by policymakers who are the one ultimately responsible for the decision-making process and can authorize or not a GM plant on the European market. Thank you.